everybody. I'm in the Littlewood, also known as Martin. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to my couch. I say welcome back. I don't think I've ever actually shot a video on here before. I've basically had to like build a semi-set before I started today. But today's video is very special because we are going to be unboxing the brand new Ni No Kuni 2 Revenant Kingdom King's Edition. So just before we get into this, I want to say thank you to Bandai Namco. This video isn't sponsored, but I still wanted to acknowledge them and say how much I appreciate them sending me this, because obviously we love the first game so much, and I'm sure this version of the game probably costs a pretty penny. So yeah, save me a few quid. Thanks, dudes. Come on then, slide. Yay, we go. We got it off at the end. So to start off with, we have got basically a sheet of information regarding the game itself. So on the back end, it seems to basically tell you about the publisher, developer, release dates, various different bullet points about the game itself, as well as the front, basically pointing out the CEO and president of Level 5, Joe Hisaishi, the composer from the previous game, is back for this game, which I'm very excited about, and also Yoshiyuki Momose, who is the character designer. Little bits of information about those guys as well, which is good. And then the very first thing is this wonderful looking book right here. It is humongous. Look at that. It is the Art of Ni No Kuni 2. And don't worry, I will actually overlay some footage right now and have a little talk through some of the stuff that is inside of here. I almost don't want to look too much because I'm worried about spoilers, but in the sort of the front end of the book, it seems to take you through the main characters to begin with. So you've got people like Lofty, who is obviously our new fairy companion. You've got Batu, the leader of the Sky Pirates. You've got Tani and Roland and Evan Pettywhisker of Tildrum. And then following that, it looks like it starts to descend into all of the various different monsters that you're going to be encountering. So the wyverns, like we saw in the previous demos, a couple of dragons here and there. So that's already a pretty damn good start. I'm going to pop this over to the side real quick. Ooh, I did not realize this would be a thing inside of here. I want to say that this is a vinyl. Oh, wait, hold on a minute. It's almost like a pop-up book. You ready for this? So this is what the front of it looks like just there. And then if we open it up, you've got a big old pop-up book, which has got Evan, Roland, and Tani doing their thing in some kind of forest, I want to say. Oh, no, actually, I tell you what, they're in front of Ding Dong Dell. Look at that. So I would be safe in assuming that, yep, this thing here feels like a vinyl. So the sound of Ni No Kuni. Let me try and bring this out, because I bet it is beautifully decorated. Okay, you ready for the big reveal? And... Oh, look at that. Wow. I didn't even realize you could print on vinyls like this. My mind is like absolutely blown right now. But there you go. There's the front of it right there. You can see the castle of Ding Dong Dell. And then on the back side of it, there are various different, like, I guess, like, dragons and monsters and various other things. I want to say maybe they're the kingmakers that I've been hearing about, which are these sort of the large guardians that protect various different towns and cities inside of Ni No Kuni. And actually, on the back of the case, it lets you know what music you can listen to on it. So we've got track number one, the theme from Ni No Kuni 2, and track number two, which is the final track, The Curious Boy. Apparently, both of these are performed by the Tokyo Philharmonic Orchestra in Tokyo, Japan, composed and directed by Joe Hisaishi. So let's take you out of the way, and ooh, what do we have next? It is the Steelbook. So the Steelbook has got Evan pictured on the front, sat upon a throne with a crown on, and he's got Roland by his side and a sword in his hilt. And as well as that, on the back side of it, we've got ourselves a dragon icon again. So on the inside of here, ooh, lots of pieces of paper. First up, we've got a season pass. Obviously won't show you the code on that one. There are various postcards as well. So the same image from the Steelbook. One of all the various different character designs that we've seen across a lot of the promotional work for the game. And then a huge sprawling shot of what can only be described as a new kingdom that I've never seen before. Maybe this is the one that we're going to be building with Evan. We've of course got a copy of the game inside of here, and then oh my god, I didn't realize this was even going to be inside of here. Dudes, I am an absolute sucker for the making of anything, like whether it's movies, TV, music, anything like that, video games. I will buy a collector's edition or a special edition just to see how things are crafted. This apparently comes with it, the Kingmakers Making of Ni No Kuni 2 Revenant Kingdom. I'm going to watch that probably before I even play the game. And then we have here what I can only assume is the sort of like snow globe that I've seen a lot of pictures of. So let's pull this out. These strings make the job very, very easy. And let's tuck on into this. I'm trying to be as careful as possible. I really, really don't want to break anything. Here we go. Oh my god. This is stunning, dude. So it's got large cat ears at the top of it because obviously Evan is half Grimalkin. And it's got one side with Evan sat by himself upon a throne, which I can only assume may have been the throne of Ding Dong Dell. And then obviously he was overthrown. And on the reverse side, you have got Tani, Roland, and Evan all there together sat upon a brand new throne. And I'm assuming if I wind this up, does it play a song as well? Oh my god, it does. Okay, hold up. It plays the main theme. Wow, that is fantastic. I genuinely didn't expect it to do that. I just thought it was something pretty to look at. I didn't realize it had a second function. I think I would be pretty safe in assuming that that is everything taken out of this box. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that is everything. So there we go. Thank you very much for watching, everybody. That is everything that you can find inside of the Ni No Kuni 2 Revenant Kingdom King's Edition. So let me know in the comment section below, what are you most excited for from the brand new game? I think from having played the demos personally, I'm actually really excited about the quicker pace between getting in and out of combat scenarios and the actual combat itself, rather than trying to juggle together lots of different familiars. It seems a lot more focused now, and you just simply change between Tarni, Evan, and Roland. You've got the Higgledies nearby for buffs and debuffs. I just think it's going to be a much smoother experience, and I can't wait to sink my teeth into it. So keep an eye on the channel for the Let's Play. That is going to be hitting your screens on March 23rd at 8 a.m. GMT. That's the earliest I'm allowed to possibly post any gameplay whatsoever from the brand new title. That's going to be a relatively long episode, and I'll probably do a second one that evening just for sort of the hype of the first day, and then of course we'll be doing daily Let's Play episodes until we finish it out. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope it was informative, I hope it was helpful, and I will see you all in a little bit. Bye bye.